Good morning to the dear people of God. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. My dear people, it is such a beautiful Friday morning. We are in the land of the living so that we can give God praise. And this morning, we just want to give him glory and honor and praise. So, Father, we praise you this morning. We lift your name on high. We say thank you this morning that we are alive and well and in our right mind. We bless you, O God, this morning. Father, we honor you. We magnify you, we glorify you, and we exalt you in this place, for you alone are worthy. Father, we honor you this morning. We exalt you and we extol you, because there is none like you this morning. There is none to compare with you this morning. You are the great and mighty God. You are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. We say, who is like unto this God? God in all the earth, we honor you this morning. Your word says, let everything that have breath praise the Lord. So we praise you this morning. We honor you this morning. We declare you as omnipotent, omnipresent, omniscient God. Great and mighty is your name. We worship you in the beauty of holiness this morning, because you are worthy of our praise this morning. You are worthy, O God, this morning. Hallelujah to the King of Kings and to the Lord of Lords. This people of God, I know you know this is the Command Your Morning segment. I'm standing in this morning for my bishop, Ayotunde Akendeli of the Kingsway Ministries this morning. So this is the time where we command our morning, where we say so, where we declare certain things, declare what we want to see into our day this morning. So I hope you are awake, and so you could join with me, and we can declare, people of God, rise up. So we can declare things into the atmosphere and put things in perspectives for our day in the name of Jesus. So we want to decree and declare this morning. I decree and declare that I take authority over this day in the name of Jesus. I decree and declare that I command the gates of the morning to open, and I command the morning to hear my voice in the name of Jesus. I decree and declare that I command the morning to take hold of the ends of the earth and shake the wicked out of it in the name of Jesus. I decree and declare that I command my day to fully cooperate with your plan and purpose for it in the name of Jesus. I decree and declare that I greet today with great anticipation of the good things you have prepared for me in the name of Jesus. I decree and declare that I destroy every demonic agenda on assignment against your people, the people of God, in the name of Jesus. I decree and declare that the scepter of wickedness shall not rest on the land allotted to the righteous, lest the righteous reach out their hands to iniquity in the name of Jesus. I decree and declare that the Lord will cause your enemies and my enemies who rise against me and you to be defeated before your face. They shall come out against you one way and flee before you seven ways in the name of Jesus. I decree and declare that the Lord will open to you his good treasure, the heavens, to give rain to your land in its season and to bless all the works of your hands in the name of Jesus. I decree and declare that you shall be blessed when you come in and when you go out in the name of Jesus. I decree and declare open heavens over your life and my life in the name of Jesus.
I decree and declare that you should not fear, for you will not be ashamed, neither will you be disgraced, for you will not be put to shame, for you will not, for you will forget the shame of your youth and will remember the reproach of widowhood, and you will not remember it anymore in the name of Jesus. I decree and declare that your barns will be filled with plenty and your vats will overflow with new wine. I decree and declare today over your life the blessings that make it rich and added no sorrows is your portion today, is my portion today in the mighty name of Jesus. My dear people of God, I just encourage you, continue to rise up and decree and declare what you want to see in your life, in your family, in your business, over your children, on your job. Continue to decree and declare in the mighty name of Jesus. The word of God declares that life and death is in the power of the tongue in the name of Jesus. There are people who rise up and decree and declare things over your life that is not good. So you need to rise up and decree and counteract what you and declare what you want to see in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And this morning I just want to encourage you, and I want to say to you that if you want to call in during the program, you can call and we will pray with you in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. So I want to read from the word of God, a scripture that you already know, and then we will pray in the mighty name of Jesus. And it's taken from Isaiah 49 verses 25 and 26. It reads, "But thus says the Lord, even the captives of the mighty shall be taken away, and the prey of the terrible be delivered." It says, "For I will contend with him who contends with you, and I will save your children. I will feed those who oppress you with their own flesh, and they shall be drunk with their own blood as with sweet wine. And all flesh shall know that I, the Lord, am your Savior and your Redeemer, the Mighty One of Jacob." People of God, this morning, you know, this little sharing before I pray, I title it "Enough is Enough." And I want to ask you this morning, people of God, are you fed up with the situations that confront you that you are facing today? Are you, just questions are asking you, have you come to the point, or are you at the stage that you want to say this morning, or you want to decree and declare to the devil this morning, enough is enough? That you had enough of the attacks, the satanic attacks. You had enough, you know, of the enemy attacking your family. You had enough of the enemy attacking your business. You had enough. Are you feeling like this morning? You need to rise up and to say enough is enough. And you need to get up and fight. I don't mean a fist fight, but a spiritual fight. And rise up. You know, I have a pastor who says you get violent, get angry in the spirit, and just get up and release some bombs against the wicked one this morning. Because I tell you this morning, his assignment is just to steal, to kill, and destroy. What is your assignment this morning, people of God? What is your assignment? What are you doing? Are you going to say enough is enough, or are you going to take licks from the enemy and just cower? People of God, God has given us the authority. He has placed the authority of the believer in us for us to rise up and to take authority. You need to get vexed and get up and fight. Fight for your children this morning. Because the enemy, if you listen to the news, the enemy is on a rampage against the children. Against youths,
He want to X out the generation. But we say no in the name of Jesus. He want to put all kinds of thing upon you in the mighty name of Jesus. He want to come against your finances. People of God, rise up and open your eyes and see. And rise up and fight in prayer. There is no room for laziness now in the kingdom. Because what? Time is getting short. Time is closing in. The word of God says, in the last days, perilous time shall come. And you know, we are a people, we're supposed to be in the world, but not of the world. And we need to fight in prayer in the mighty name of Jesus. We need to rise up. Remember, you know, as we go to pray, remember Hannah. Hannah was going through some experiences with Penina. You know the story, I don't want to go into it. But the year that she went up, to worship God, she was so angry. You know, the man of God thought she was drunk, but she just spoke directly to God and just, oh, they say only her lips move. She spoke in her heart. People of God, Jacob wrestled with the angel of God all night. His hip was dislocated, but he didn't give up. I want to say to you this morning, there comes a time, and I'm talking to myself too, there comes a time when we have to say enough is enough. Enough is enough. We need to rise up, shake our covers off, shake laziness off, and fight against this old slew foot, as an old lady would tell me. This old slew foot, in the mighty name of Jesus. You know, the one who he wants to bring all kind of thing upon the people of God. But we say no to him this morning, and we say enough is enough, in the mighty name of Jesus. So, you know, and he worked with imps and agents. We want to pray against them this morning. And we want to say, because our God, people of God, running helter and skelter doesn't change things. Or going to Egypt for help. The answer is in prayer, calling to Almighty God, the one who is the prayer answering God, the one who is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we can think or ask or desire in the mighty name of Jesus. So this morning, join with me this morning. The word says, when any two agree, and I know that you are numerous this morning, that you're joining me. It's not I alone here this morning. I know that you're joining me this morning. We want to say enough is enough in the mighty name of Jesus. We want to take authority over every plan of the wicked one this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. Father God, we thank you this morning. Father God, we praise you this morning as we approach your throne room, oh God. Your word has come boldly to the throne of grace that we could obtain mercy and find help in the time of need. So we come before you this morning. We give you thanks this morning, Father, because we know that you are a prayer answering God. Even as we approach your throne room this morning, we bless your name and we magnify you, oh God. Your people are saying enough is enough this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. Father God, we bless you, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. We want to pray this morning, Father, we take authority over every agent of frustration. Begin to lose your hold over the lives of the people of God this morning. You agent of frustration. That is what you want to bring upon your people, frustration, in the mighty name of Jesus. We say, loose your hold over the lives of your people, over the people of God. Loose your hold in the mighty name of Jesus. You agents of frustration, loose your hold. Loose your hold over the lives of your people this morning. Your people saying enough is enough. We say the blood of Jesus is against you in the mighty name of Jesus. All agents of poverty, begin to lose your hold. You agents of poverty, begin to lose your hold in the mighty name of Jesus. You agents of poverty, begin to lose your hold. We declare, God, we shall not go down. We shall not be poor. Because our daddy owns a cattle on a thousand hills. We declare, God, Father, that we shall not beg bread. We shall not beg bread in the mighty name of Jesus. Father God, your word declares that you never see the righteous forsaken or his seed begging bread. We declare that we will not beg. We will not beg bread in the mighty name of Jesus. We take authority all over all the agents of poverty. We bind your work. We say, loose your hold over the lives of your people in the mighty name of Jesus. We say, loose your hold in the mighty name of Jesus. You agents of poverty, we say, give up in the mighty name of Jesus. We say, the blood of Jesus is against you. We say, enough is enough in the name of Jesus. We declare that we shall not be poor in the mighty name of Jesus. We declare, God, and we say, loose your hold in the mighty name of Jesus. We take authority over every agent of defeat in the mighty name of Jesus. You agent of defeat that the people of God are experiencing, defeat, defeat, defeat. We take authority over you in the mighty name of Jesus. We cancel your plans, agent of defeat. We say, loose your hold over the lives of your people. Your people says, enough is enough. And we decree success in the mighty name of Jesus. You agents of defeat, we say, loose your hold over the lives of your people, of the people of God, in the name of Jesus. Loose your hold, agents of defeat. Loose your hold in the mighty name of Jesus. Loose your hold in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We declare that enough is enough over the lives of the people of God in the name of Jesus. We come against the agents of infirmity, the one that wants to bring sickness and disease over the lives of your people. We say, loose your hold. You agents of defeat, agents of infirmity, loose your hold. You spirit of death, you agents of infirmity, loose your hold in the name of Jesus. The word of God declared, by the stripes of God, your people are healed in the name of Jesus. We decree, oh God, that sickness and disease is not the portion of the people of God in the mighty name of Jesus. Agents of infirmity, loose your hold. Loose your hold in the mighty name of Jesus. Loose your hold in the mighty name of Jesus. You agents of infirmity, loose your hold. And we decree and declare, oh God, that healing is the truest bread in the mighty name of Jesus. We decree and declare that they shall not die, but they will live in the name of Jesus. We decree and declare that by the stripes of God, they are healed in the name of Jesus. So we command you, agents of infirmity, loose your hold in the mighty name of Jesus. And we decree and declare that enough is enough in the mighty name of Jesus. Because our God is Jehovah Rapha, who paid the price on the cross. He bore healing on his wings as he lay on the tree in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We come against every agent of confusion. I say, loose your hold. Loose your hold. We release the fire of God. We reverse every confusion back to the sender in the mighty name of Jesus. We decree and declare that enough is enough in the name of Jesus. We bind the spirit of confusion. We reverse it to the camp of the enemy in the mighty name of Jesus. We decree confusion in the camp of the enemy. We decree that you will fight among yourselves in the mighty name of Jesus. We come against every agent of confusion in the mighty name of Jesus. Because God, the word of God, as I read in Isaiah, he said, I will contend with them that contend with you. So, Father, contend against them. Contend against them in the mighty name of Jesus. Your word says that you will feed them with their own flesh and let them drink their own blood. So we release them, we reverse the spirit of confusion in the mighty name of Jesus. And we decree and declare that enough is enough. Enough is enough. Enough is enough. We stamp upon the spirit of confusion in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name. We come against all agents of backward movement. Begin to loose your hold over the people. Hallelujah. We take authority over that spirit of backward movement. You know, instead of the people of God going forward, we declare, you know, they're taking steps backward in the mighty name of Jesus. We decree and declare, you agents of backward movement, loose your hold in the name of Jesus. And we declare, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus, forward motion in the name of Jesus. forward motion in the mighty name of Jesus. We come against every backward movement, everything presented by the enemy to send your people how many steps backward. We say, loose your hold. You agents of backward movements, we say to you, the blood of Jesus is against you and the fire of God is against you this morning. We take authority over every spirit of backward movement. You agents of backward movements, we declare, we say, no, enough is enough this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. Agents of backward movement, we trample upon you today in the name of Jesus. I decree and declare that your people shall march forward. They shall go forward in the name of Jesus. Upward, they shall move higher and higher in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In the mighty name of Jesus. We want to pray this morning again in the name of Jesus as we say enough is enough. Let all wicked oppressors. The word of God says that oppression shall be far from you in the mighty name of Jesus. We want to pray that all wicked oppressors stumble and fall in every area. In every area the oppressors want to come of your life in the name of Jesus. Over your life, over my life. We want to say that all, let every wicked oppressor stumble and fall. We say, you wicked oppressors, we command you to stumble and fall in whatever area you want to come in the lives of the people. We command you to stumble. Spirit of wicked oppressors, we say, stumble and fall. Stumble and fall. Stumble and fall in the mighty name of Jesus. We say the blood. We release the fire of God against you in the name of Jesus. The word, as Isaiah said, I will contend with you. You contend, Father, contend with the wicked oppressors in the name of Jesus. Feed them with their own flesh and let it drink their blood. And everyone shall know that this is the Lord and he has done it in the name of Jesus. You wicked oppressors, we say stumble and fall in the mighty name of Jesus. My God, you will feed them with their own flesh and let it drink their own blood in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We want to come against, as we say, enough is enough. All agents of demonic delays. You're starting to do, it's just like you're waiting on something. Everything just delay, delay, delay. We want to come against every agent of delays in the mighty name of Jesus. We say, loose your hold this morning. You agents, you're one working to bring delays in the name of Jesus. We release the fire. We release the thunder and bolt and lightning of God. The thunder and lightning of God against you. We come against every hindrance and every obstacle. We say, clear the world in the name of Jesus. We come against every demonic delays in the name of Jesus. We, Father God, we declare the path cleared in the name of Jesus. We come against those obstacles, the hindrances in the name of Jesus, the mountains in the mighty name of Jesus that brings delays. We say, be made flat in the name of Jesus. You mountains of delay, be made flat in the name of Jesus. Become a plain in the name of Jesus. You agents of demonic delays, we release the thunder, release the bombs of God against you in the mighty name of Jesus. We cut your hand off. We cut off every part of your body, every hindrance, every obstacle of demonic delays. We say we drive you away with a spiritual backhoe in the name of Jesus. With the thunderbolt of God in the name of Jesus. We drive you out. We say clear away in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. We want to come against instruments, all instruments of failure, fashioned against the lives of your people. Failure. Failure in the mighty name of Jesus. We say, receive the fire of God and be roasted in the mighty name of Jesus. We say, enough is enough for failure in the mighty name of Jesus. Instruments of failure. Receive fashion to come against the people of God. Receive the fire of God and be roasted in the name of Jesus. You instruments of failure, receive the fire of God and be roasted in the name of Jesus. We say, get out of the lives of your people. We declare success over the lives of your people in the mighty name of Jesus. We decree, oh God, that your people are the head. They are not the tail in the mighty name of Jesus. They are above and not beneath in the mighty name of Jesus. We take authority over every instrument of failure in the mighty name of Jesus. We say, enough is enough. Enough is enough over the lives of the people of God. We say, be take fire and be roasted in the mighty name of Jesus. Take fire and be roasted in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We want to come against all agents of debt. You know, you owe this one. You can't pay this one. You owe all agents of debt. You owe the bank. You can't see your way. You're above. You're up to your throat in debt. We command every agent of debt, begin to loose your hold over the lives of your people. Hallelujah. The word says the one gives who give us power to get wealth in the mighty name of Jesus. God, we say, God, enough is enough. Satan, take your hands off of the people. Off of the people of God and the finances. We come against all agents of death in the mighty name of Jesus. We take authority over you in the mighty name of Jesus. Your people shall not go down in the mighty name of Jesus. We remove all hanging debts, hanging over the lives of your people. We command them to be cleared in the mighty name of Jesus. We say, loose your hold, loose your grip over the lives of the people of God in the mighty name of Jesus. Loose your hold over the lives of the people of God in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Your people shall rise up, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And my final prayer point, you know, let all locked up blessings rebel and come out of the prison. In the name of Jesus. All locked up blessings, all the blessings of God, the blessings that make it rich and add up no sorrows, we command you to rebel and to come out of the prison where you are, and the people of God can receive in the name of Jesus. We say, all locked up blessings, come out, rebel, come out of the prison. The people of God are waiting to receive. Your people of God are waiting to receive in the name of Jesus. We say, all locked up blessings, come out. Come out of the prison. Rebel and come out, and the people of God will receive you in the mighty name of Jesus. My dear people of God, this morning, continue to pray. Don't give up. Don't give up in the mighty name of Jesus. There comes a time you have to turn off the TV. All the other things, put down your phone. Put down your phone and call upon the name of the Lord who is worthy to be praised. Your blessing that is locked up, and say to the devil, enough is enough. It is time to fight for your blessing. It is time to fight for what belongs to you. Satan is a defeated foe in the name of Jesus. I declare this morning that Jesus Christ is Lord over everything, over your life, over your situations. He's able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we can think or ask or desire in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.